Hey everybody, this is Nick Baldwin, and today I'm being joined by UFC welterweight contender Santiago Ponzinibbio, who has a big fight coming up this weekend against Geoff Neal at UFC 269 in Las Vegas. Santiago, how are you?
Hey, what's up, brother? Everything good, man. I'm excited. I'm here in Vegas. I can't wait, man.
When did you get to Vegas? Because I know Tuesday is usually the big travel day for fighters, check-in day. When did you get to Vegas?
Early? I arrived here last Friday night. I work in last Saturday here in the fight. I do the broadcasting in Spanish, and I work in here in the fight on Saturday, and after that, I stay here.
Wow, so you went to Vegas early just so you could commentate, correct?
Yeah. I work in a lot with the broadcasting. I enjoy, and I need to come in here. I'm back. I'm coming a little early. I work on Saturday. Yep.
So there's a fight. Yeah. Sorry?
No, I'm going to stay for the all week here. Fight on the 11th, and I'm back on the 18th for broadcasting on the last show.
A lot of commentators that are also fighters, like back when DC was still active, Dominic Cruz, Michael Bisping, I guess, not Bisping, he was retired already, but a lot of guys, they take time off from commentating when they have a fight coming up during their camp. You didn't. How was it commentating just a week before your fight, and why did you still commentate this close to your fight?
I think it changed nothing, man. I'm professional. I did everything good in my camp. I did everything well with my weight. My weight are good. My camp are good. If I need to come in, if I'm not working, I come in on Sunday to Vegas, probably, for I like to stay a couple of days here, right? If we come in between Sunday and Saturday and work, it doesn't matter for me. No, it changes nothing, you know. I enjoy the work. I like to watch the fight, study the fight, you know. There's some work that I really enjoy, and I think it's not affecting my game and nothing, you know. Just they increase me, they give me, you know. It's good stay involved in the fights. I watching a lot of fights. That's good for me, you know.
Do you have to is it difficult to balance both fighting and commentating? Do you have to work hard to balance them? Like, as you said, you're going to be commentating on December 18th, a week after your fight. That's something you have to prepare for. You have to get ready for. Is it tough to sort of go between being a commentator and a fighter so quickly?
No, it depends on everybody, man. Everybody are different, man. Everybody are different. Some people need more time. Some people, you know, don't like, you know. I enjoy, man. I'm happy. I'm thankful the opportunity, you know. I'm happy when I broadcast in the fight. I like to watch fights. The change, the weekends. And, you know, if I'm not working, I'm staying home. Doing with my friends now, it's coming to work. That's the difference, you know. But not changing nothing, man. I enjoy always coming to Vegas. I do my PT, my training here. You know, I have a lot of. We have the Institute Performance here in Vegas. You know, we have a lot of good support, and always coming here, still training, still eating clean, still doing all the stuff that I need to do for staying my professional career, and also working with the broadcasting. I enjoy and I really like it, man.
In some ways, does it actually get you kind of ready for the fight? Like when you called the Jose Aldo Rob Font fight this past weekend, like you're at the arena, you're at the Apex. Like, does it kind of get you in fight mentality? Like, does it get you ready in some ways?
I love, man. I saw this war in life, man. And they give me excited. They give me, man, I want to fight too. You're still, brother. That's unbelievable fight. I love this fight, man. Jose Aldo have, man, an incredible card. Amazing fight. I'm so happy to have the opportunity to broadcast in this fight.
Yeah, what a card that was. There are so many knockouts and submissions. Yeah, great
all
card.
The card. Right, all the card, not only this fight. 13 fights, so many knockouts, submissions. This amazing card. And also, Aldo and Fon, they doing the best fight. I love, man. But for sure, I really enjoy staying there watching the fight. This, for me, is great.
So your fight on Saturday against Geoff Neal, it got moved up to the pay-per-view main card after the cancellation of Leon Edwards versus Jorge Masvidal. When you found out that you would now be on the paid portion, you'd be on the main card, how did you feel about that?
That's good, man. It's more eyes watching my work, you know. I'm so many years in this game, so many years in this company. I have 17 fights, you know. I won 14. I did a lot of stuff. I'm excited to this opportunity, right? This is the last pay-per-view of the year, big card, a lot of good names, and also I'm behind the two belts. There's a great position to can show to the world my work, you know, to show to the world who I am and all her what I come in doing
between this being years. Does being on the main card get you even more excited, or does it not really matter that much at the end of the day?
Oh, no, give me more excited for sure. That's a good okay. thing, you know. I'm happy behind two belts, man, and I know a lot of people watching the fight, and they give me more excited, you know, for sure. That's a good opportunity to show my work.
In your last fight, you returned to the win column against Miguel Baeza. It was one of the best fights of the year. Decision win for you. After losing your return and then have, you know, of course, the layoff, the couple years off, how good did it feel to finally get that win?
It's good, man. I need that. You know I'm one of the best fighters in the world, but I need to prove for the people. I think the fight with Lee just lucky punch, you know, that's it, nothing more, you know. He not beat me for 10, 15 minutes. He only gave me one punch. I started slow in activity for a long time, but it's about the past. I don't care. Right now, I am 8-1, my last 9 fights. I beat 2 times a number 8 in the world. I beat so many good guys. Sean Strickland, when he's underfeet, 15-0, but he's underfeet. Mike Perry, when he come in winning, he's number 15 when they give me the fight. Cummings, when they come in winning. You know, Taleb, when he come in the over, the knockout, Derek Silva. Always I take the guys in that good moment, the him carrying. I did well, man. A1, I'm going to have a good opponent right now, but I'm better fighter. I'm going to smash this guy. I'm going to win this fight. Man, I put 9-10. Man, I'm going to show to the world I'm one of the best fighters in the world. I have an opportunity soon for the belt.
I think when you lost that fight to Li Jingliang, there were a few people that were sort of saying after the fight, hey, maybe Santiago, his best days are behind him. Do you think this win over Baeza proved those people wrong?
Right, for sure, 100%. You know, that's, man, that's a lucky punch. He not beat me for 10, 15 minutes, nothing. It's just only one punch. This can happen. We can see this all the time. This is MMA. For this sport is unbelievable, you know, exciting for this, you know, the small glove, brother. It's one punch. It's no better technique than me. You know, I'm better fighting. Hopefully, I can fight with him again. I think if I fight in 10 times, I'm going to win 9, you know. But this is MMA, and that's it. This is about the past, man. But I bag with Baeza. I give her punches. I take her punches. The case is slippery. I can't do my game in the first round. He hurt me a lot. I back to the second round, changed my strategy. After I am damaged, and I put my hurt and my strategy in the third one, the third round, and I beat this guy. They come in with a lot of confidence. He's underfeet. I showed to the world. I am back to the game. The Jingla Lee just only lucky punching. And 8-1 in my last 9 fights. And I'm going to show again this Saturday, man. I'm going to smash this guy, Neil. You know, it's nothing personal. It's just business. But, you know, so many years in this sport, so many ups and downs, you know, and, you know, right now I am feeling my prime moment. Yeah, I'm gonna show to the world that, you know.
Do you hope to have a rematch with Jingliang at some point?
Yeah, my goal right now is the belt. It's not a rematch with him, but yeah, for sure. I like this rematch too, you know.
Okay. There was a bit of news with your opponent, Geoff Neal, last week on Thanksgiving Day. He was arrested on charges of DWI and a gun charge. When you found us out, did the UFC reach out to you? Did they say anything to you?
No, nobody say nothing for me. I don't care. What is he doing? If he go to fight with me, this is what I need to show my work, to show who I am. I don't care nothing about him, what is he doing, you know?
Were you worried the fight could be canceled? Did that go through your mind at all?
Yeah, when they saw the news, I say, hopefully if cancel put other guy, you know, for realistic, I don't think in, you know, in fight Geoff Neal. I think in the opportunity. I don't care about this guy, you know. If he no fight, move this guy and put other guy. I don't care. Give me opportunity to show the world, you know. Give opportunity to take the time I lose, to time off, you know, to show who I am, you know, for the people. This is what I like, you know.
So was there any communication from the UFC as far as, yes, the fight will happen? Like, did they talk to you, your manager? Nobody. Did they say anything?
Nobody told me.
Hmm. So you, I mean, I know they talked to ESPN. They said the fight's not in jeopardy. But are you, were you ever kind of thinking like, hey, I don't know if this fight's going to happen, and they're not saying anything? Like, were you kind of frustrated at all, or you didn't really care?
I don't care, man. I don't care if probably if he pull up to the fight, if so many guys try to jump in there for it's a great opportunity, you know, in the pay-per-view show. They give me somebody. I don't care. Put somebody there in front of me to me smash.
You were confident that even if Neal didn't make it to the fight, you would still have an opponent.
Yeah.
That's, you know, one way or another. What do you think Neal getting into this trouble with the law sort of says about his preparation and maybe the advantage you have over him? Like, does that say, do you feel like he maybe isn't preparing as well as he should be? Does that say anything about him leading up to this fight?
I don't care, man. If he not prepared, it's his problem, you know? He's going to feel a lot of pain in this fight, you know? I'm more than ready, brother. It's about him. I don't care, man. If he prepared well, that's good. They're gonna give me more value in my victory, you know. If he not prepare, he gonna earn this shit, you know. But this is not my problem.
Yeah. So I believe this is number 12 in the welterweight division versus number 14. What do you think is at stake against Geoff Neal on Saturday?
Man, I come into winning the fight, you know. I do my best camp and my prime moment, you know. And I'm ready to beat this guy and move forward, man. I deserve to stay in the best fighters in the world. I know I have the talent for that. I know they have the power to be champion of the world. You know, I need my opportunity. I'm going to take this opportunity on Saturday to show my work and continue moving forward.
So in your opinion, would it only make sense to have a top 10 opponent if you beat Geoff Neal?
I think so, man. It's too many. 9 on 10 winning this fight. You, a journalist, told me how many guys won in 9 on 10 fights and not stay in the top 5 or not fighting for the belt, you know? I was number 6, brother. I knocked him out 2 times, number 8 in the world. I beat so many good guys. I don't think the rankings are fair, you know? I don't believe. I think I deserve, you know, still high ranking, but I don't care, man. I'm going to do my work and 8. I won 8 on my last 9. I'm going to win 9 on my last 10, you know, and I continue moving forward.
What do you think would be a fair ranking for you right now?
Fair ranking?
Like, where would you put yourself in the division?
In the top 6 for sure, man.
Okay.
Two times I fought with number 8 in the world. I know just one. I knock him out. I finish. I fought Sean Strickland when he's under feet on 15. No, you know, I beat Mike Perry when he's number 15. You know, I beat Sakami when he coming victories. Tale when he coming over knockout. The Eric Silva. I take the guys always in the good moment that he carrying, you know, when they come in the victories and I beat the guys, smash the guy, you know. That's Baez under feet, 10-0. He coming very confident, you know. I did a lot of work, man.
If you get the win,
deserve to be there, you know.
Yeah. If you get the win on Saturday, do you plan to sort of call your shot? You post fight interview, you get on the mic and call someone out, top 5, top 10, whatever it is. Like, do you want to make the most of that opportunity on the mic?
Yeah, for sure, man. Always use. It's important. Use the opportunity in the mic. I don't care who, but I like to have the opportunity to fight with somebody in the top 5 after this victory.
All right. Well, last thing, Santiago, how does this fight end? How do you beat Geoff Neal on Saturday night?
I'm ready to finish him, man, to knock him out him. But if he like to stand up, he's going to feel pain for 15 minutes. It's about him. I don't care. I'm ready to finish this fight.
All right, Santiago, thanks so much for the time. I appreciate it, and best of luck to you on Saturday.
Thank you, my man. Have a great day.